লাঞ্চ প্লেট দেখো ওদের আগেকার দিনের
कैसे
साउंड है ये
We had been on a 12 days long road trip through the roads of the Deccan Plateau, where we explored many hidden treasures of the region. And it was our day 5 as we drove into the historical and magical land of Hampi. We checked in at Hotel Mayura Bhuvaneshwari, managed by Karnataka Tourism, where our plan was to stop over for the next 4 nights. Hampi is one such heritage site where there is much to see and explore. We didn't want to miss anything, so we quickly freshened up and started for our day one tour of Hampi. Our first stop was at the Queen's Bath, situated close to the royal enclosure. The Queen's Bath is a heritage site which is simple to look at from outside but has ornately carved interior designs. This royal pool was built by King Achyuta Raya of the Vijayanagara Empire. It used to be a private bathing chamber for the ladies of the royal family. The pool is rectangular in shape and 8 feet deep. The rectangular pool is surrounded by a veranda on all sides with multiple arches opening into the pool. The veranda has sets of 3 windows projecting into the open pool. There are several ducts opening into this pool which were meant to supply fresh water. These ducts are connected to water channels for bringing water from the river into the pool. A flight of stone steps lead down to the bath which is now devoid of any water. As I took a walk around the veranda, I could imagine the activity here of the bygone era where the water in the pond used to be filled with the petals of fragrant flowers and perfumes. It was a spa for the ladies of the royal family. The entire structure is surrounded by a moat on all sides which used to remain filled with water. We then proceeded towards the royal enclosure which once used to be the seat of power and heart of the Vijayanagara Empire. This royal enclosure was a fortified area where now we can find several interesting relics from the bygone era. One needs to be prepared to walk over here as it spreads over several acres of land. This was the place where the royal family of the Vijayanagara Empire used to live. Near the entrance, we found a huge stone door lying on the ground which was neatly carved. Our guide showed us the locking system at the back of the door. This path after the stone door was the main entrance leading towards the royal enclosure. There are stone walls on both the sides. As per our guide, these stone walls are filled with mortar and bricks inside.
कौन सा?
ये 16 सेंचुरी का है, ये डिपार्टमेंटल आप लगा दिए सो।
ओके।
इसमें अंदर मिट्टी है, ये पत्थर भर दिए भैया पूरा भी।
ये पहले का है?
पहले का है, ये आपका है भैया।
अभी का है?
ये राजा अंदर जाने के लिए एंट्रेंस है ये।
ओके।
कृष्ण देवराया।
ये कैसे
कट करने का तरीका भैया? पहला होल बनाने के बाद छाले रख के मार देते, पत्थर कट हो जाता। इधर आओ, इधर बता देते।
We saw some big stones lying around with small holes made into it. Our guide explained that it was the technology used for cutting rocks. These holes were made in such a way that it helped to cut the rocks into proper pieces. One of the most impressive structure inside the royal enclosure is the Mahanavami Dibba or the Dasera Dibba, where 9 days of Navaratri festival was celebrated. It is a stone platform which is around 25 feet in height. This entire unit is a giant square structure built in 3 layers. From a distance it appears like an ordinary elevated square stage. The details emerge as you go nearby. The sides of this 3-layered platform has continuous chains of designs showing elephants and horses. There are sculptures showing hunting scenes.
वो चंदन के लकड़ी से बना हुआ डबल फ्लोर आता ऊपर दुर्गा देवी का लक्ष्मी का मूर्ति रख के उस पत्थर का पानी ले लेकर के पूजा करते थे ऊपर ऊपर कृष्णा देवराय बैठ के सैनिक लोग सभी हीरे मोती देने का स्टेज है भैया.
There used to be continuous festival during the 9 days of Navaratri. Governors and kings from other provinces also visited during this time to pledge their loyalty to the emperor. In the end, the king used to distribute gifts in the form of gold and silver to his subjects while sitting at the top. Traders from distant countries such as China, Arabia, Portugal, and Egypt used to visit over here for the purpose of trading.
पूरा है भैया, ये साइड में निकाल लेना, ये सभी उधर बाजू भी हाथी घोड़ा ऊंट लेके जा रहे ना, विदेशी लोग आके फंक्शन मनाते थे ऊपर.
ये सब
हाँ, ये सभी है ना, उस टाइम पे गांधारी विवाह बोल के ये सभी वो माला पहन रहे सो, उसको माला डाल रहे, ये माला.
अरे राइट, ये वाला.
हाँ ये वाला है, देखो गांधारी विवाह बोल के कर लेते थे, रजिस्टर मैरिज करते ना ऐसा.
देयर आर टू स्टेयरवेज टू रीच टू द टॉप. The front one is beautifully decorated on either sides with carvings of elephants, horses, and a host of other things.
ये सभी है देखो, उस टाइम पे उस समय में पूरा नाश हो गया सुबह, हत्ती दो भी उधर का एक इधर का हत्ती है ना, पूरा भी कट हो गया मेरा, उधर भी कट हो गया.
वो लोग तोड़ दिया?
हाँ तोड़ दिए भैया. वो हत्ती में पेट में कुछ भी सुना रहता बोल के निकाल के भी तोड़ के भी चले गए.
कौन लोग?
वो बहुमनी सुल्तान वाले.
The sculptures show everything starting from the royal ceremonies to the life of the common citizens at the time.
এগুলো সব ভেঙে গেছে. এদিকে আসো. এই যে. কার পা এলো তো?
Upon reaching to the top, one gets a view of the entire campus of the royal enclosure spreading over several miles. King Krishna Devaraya used to sit at the top and watch the soldiers doing march past, various sports and war games. Royal processions were organized also. There were also song and dance performances. While While coming down, we observed several wall carvings showing regular connections with traders from far-off lands. Some carvings show facial features of people belonging to far-off lands such as Portugal, China, Egypt, and Arabia. We came down the staircase to find multiple carvings depicting hunting scenes and scenes of war preparations.
ये देखो hunting. ये ऊँट ऊँट का चल ऊँट.
हाँ ऊँट अरब से आया सो भैया.
अरब से.
अरब से.
अरब से आया सो.
आया थे.
क्यों बोला तो ये देखो 9 दिन का function चलता भैया 10वां दिन को कोई भी जीते सलंग से भी बख्शीश करके सोना चांदी देते हैं.
अरब से भी लोग आते थे
मैडम
ट्रेडिंग के लिए.
पहला विजयनगर में यहाँ चलता था मैडम. ये पूरा नाश होने के बाद मैसूर में शिफ्ट किया राजावाड़ी और बोल के कंटिन्यू कर लेके जा रहे मैडम.
On the walls, one can find several carvings of camels, and we came to know from our guide that traders from far-off lands such as Arabia brought camels over here. We then proceeded towards a structure which looked like a reservoir for storing water.
ये देखिए होली टैंक है. राजा के परिवार लोग इसमें रंग मिला के खेलते थे दशहरा के टाइम पे.
As per our guide, this was a pool used during Holi festival. Colors were added into the water of the pool, and this water was used for playing Holi. We could see that there were long stretches of water channels which were carved out of stone.
अभी भी पाइपलाइन है पानी नहीं आता. 500 साल पीछे पानी आता था. 500 साल पीछे पीयूसी पाइप नहीं आता. पत्थर के चैनल में बना लेके एक्वाडेट बोल के.
These water channels spread throughout the huge area and were used for supplying water throughout the royal enclosure. And all these engineering marvels 500 to 600 years back. We are now proceeding towards the Pushkarini inside the enclosure, popularly known as the stepped tank. This stepped tank was discovered by the Archaeological Survey of India in 1984 when they followed the direction of the water channels which brought them here. This stepped tank was completely hidden under the soil. ASI team excavated and found this beautifully designed Pushkarini. Pushkarinis in Hampi are those water reservoirs which were associated mainly with the temples, as the water was used for various activities related to the temples. There used to be a Lakshmi temple right in front. The steps made of black stones are in perfect measurement. Steps on every side are arranged in the form of an attractive pyramidal shape to get to the next level.
आप writing से उसको सभी यहाँ भी ये देखो writing.
कौन लिखा?
23 वो उस टाइम पे लिखे.
उस टाइम पे लिखे.
इस लेवल मिट्टी इतनी ना खोद के ब्रश करे तो नंबर ऐसा छाता हो.
और ये सब उस टाइम पे लिखा हुआ है.
उस टाइम पे लिख दिया सो.
There are symbols, numerals, and Kannada letters inscribed on the steps. For example, some of the letters tell us the direction of water flow. As there are inscriptions on the steps, hence no one is allowed to step on these. It is one of the most beautiful structure which we have seen in Hampi.
Lunch plate, dekho.
We are now going to see the rock cut thalis or plates which were used by the soldiers during those times. Many of the thalis has multiple bowls cut into the plate suitably for serving a complete meal. It is difficult in this age to imagine that plates could be made of rocks which could be of such a huge size and weight. The plates were made out of rock and iron metal, which is evident from the sound emitted from them.
देखो साउंड.
अरे कैसे साउंड है ये?
आयरन मिक्सर आता ना भैया साउंड आ जाता है ब्लैक ग्रीन साउंड आने का.
The water channel is placed right above so that after finishing a meal, the plates could be washed right over here.
Wash well, sir.
हाँ.
Very good. और कुछ है इधर?
हाँ अभी सीक्रेट चैम्बर है.
चलो चलो.
We are now heading towards the secret chamber or the underground meeting room of the king. Join us in our next video to watch more about this prosperous empire and their beautiful creations more than 500 to 600 years back.